Hello, programmers. This discussion covers scope, visibility, and lifetime of variables. Here is a list of topics in the presentation: definition of terms, local and global variables, and automatic versus static memory allocation. The scope resolution operator, :, will be briefly mentioned. It really needs to be covered when objects and object-oriented programming are discussed. Although several terms relating to scope, visibility, and lifetime are defined at the beginning of the presentation, they may not make fully sense until you see how they're used in the code for an actual program. Scope: range of program statements that can access a variable. Visibility: a variable is visible within its scope. Lifetime: the amount of time a variable or object remains in memory. Local variables are declared inside a function and can only be used within that function. The memory locations for local variables are not initialized to any specific value, but contain whatever was left in them the last time those locations were used by some other part of the program. Global variables are declared outside of any function and, if visible, can be seen by any function. Changing a global variable in any function changes it globally. Global variables are initialized to zero when the variables are declared. Programs use an area of memory called a stack when working with blocks of code. The stack in memory is similar to a stack of dishes in a cupboard. We might place dishes one at a time on the top of the stack and remove them from the stack in reverse order. Anytime a block of code is entered, any local variables within the block are placed in an area of memory called the stack. When a function is called, the return address is also placed on the stack. They remain on the stack as long as the function is active, but when the function ends, that area of the stack is no longer needed and the memory locations that were used are released and can be used when a new function call occurs. It does not even need to be the same function that is called, since the memory will be reused for something completely different from the current execution of the code for this function. It can be said that the contents of the variable are lost and no longer available when the function goes out of scope. Automatic variables are just given a space on the stack in memory when a block of code is entered. Automatic variables in C and C++ do not have their memory contents initialized, but are left with whatever happens to be in those memory cells the last time they were used. It is for this reason that local variables must be initialized before being used, or you will be working with garbage data. Static variables are placed in the program space of memory, are initialized to zero, and keep the same memory location for as long as the program is in memory. In C and C++, static variables can only be initialized using constant literals. Variables have a data type, such as int, double, character, etc., a name by which the rest of the program uses the variable, memory allocated to hold the data. Different data types use different amounts of memory. An int uses 4 bytes of memory, a double uses 8 bytes of memory, and a character uses 2 bytes. Objects in object-oriented programming, OOP, are declared in a similar way to simple variables. When writing an object-oriented program, objects are created, or should I say instantiated, from a class definition. A class is like a blueprint for a building that shows how the building is to be constructed, but is not the building itself. An object is built from the class definition and occupies memory when the program runs. Multiple objects can be instantiated from a single class definition. If I want to declare an integer and name it value 1, I enter int value 1 semicolon. At this point, value 1 is assigned enough memory to hold an integer, and all the operations that can be performed on integers are available to value 1. If a class definition is already defined for rational, I can instantiate an object of type rational and name it value 2, entering rational value 2 semicolon. Now, value 2 is assigned enough memory to hold a rational object, and all the operations that are available for a rational object are available to value 2. Although objects tend to be more complicated than simple data types, objects have the same scope, visibility, and lifetime rules as simple variables. The global variable is located outside of any block of code. The memory for the global variable is allocated when the program is compiled. The global variables remain in memory as long as the program is in memory. An automatic local variable is located within a block of code defined by the curly braces. Memory for automatic local variables is allocated when the function is entered. The function arguments are also automatic local variables, argc, argv, and x. Memory for these variables is allocated when the function is entered. The memory used by the automatic local variables is released as soon as the program exits the block of code. The memory for argc, argv, and value is released when the program is exited. The memory for x and z is released when the update value function is exited. The data stored in an automatic local variable is lost when the memory for the variable is released. The variable I is an automatic local variable and exists only while the for statement and its block of code is being executed. I no longer exists in memory, and its contents is lost as soon as the for statement is done executing. The scope of a variable refers to the part of the program that can access the variable. In order for a variable to be visible, it must have scope, and it must be defined before an attempt is made to access the variable. Namespace scope gives the program access to names that are declared within the namespace. If you do not want to use the line, using namespace standard, semicolon, you can explicitly identify the namespace for the cout and cn using the scope resolution operator, colon, colon, std, colon, colon, cout, less than, less than, quote, enter a number, quote, less than, std, colon, colon, endl. Class scope will be covered when classes are introduced. Here is a fairly simple program that computes taxes for three people using a flat tax rate of 20% on the income after subtracting $4,200 from the income for each dependent. The program has main and two functions. The first function computes the exemption dollar amount for the dependents, and the second function computes the tax. Two variables are defined at the top of the program for exemption amount and flat tax. These are global variables and can be accessed by any part of the program. Function prototypes are provided for the two subroutines compute exemptions and compute tax. Main declares an integer I and sets it to 75. It is reinitialized to a zero at the beginning of the for loop. Three passes are made through the for loop. While I is a 0, 1, and 2, when I becomes a 3, the for loop ends. Inside the for loop, a cout prompts for income, and cn reads the income from the keyboard. Another cout and cn get the number of dependents. The compute exemption function computes the dollar exemptions using the number of dependents, and the compute tax function computes the tax. Finally, a cout statement displays the tax to the console. I, income, dependents, exemptions, and tax are local variables to the block of code for main. Main also has access to the global variables. The compute exemptions function has two local variables, dependents and exemptions. Dependents is declared as an int as a parameter on the function definition, while exemptions is declared as a double inside the block of curly braces. Both of these variables exist only within the block of code within the curly braces. Looking at main, we can see that it also has declarations for dependents and exemptions. Although the variables in main and the compute exemptions function have the same name, as far as the code execution goes, they are totally separate variables and even are in different memory locations. The compute exemptions function does not have access to the variables in main. and main does not have access to the variables in the function. It is the return statement that would be passing the computation result back into main, which can then store the result into its variable named exemptions. The compute tax function computes the tax and saves it in its own variable named your tax, which is then returned to the main program. Main then stores the returned value into its local variable named tax and then displays the tax for the person. Compute tax also has a local variable named counter that I want to use to display the number of times the function is called. Unfortunately, each time the function is called, it gets a new memory allocated to its local variables, and counter is reinitialized to a zero each time the function is entered. The way it is currently coded, an output message will always show tax is computed for person 1. See the plus plus counter? Counter is incremented from a 0 to a 1 before it's used by the cout statement. By making the declaration for counter static, it no longer is an automatic variable located on the stack and reinitialized each time the function is entered. Static int counter semicolon now keeps the same memory location for the entire time the program is in memory. Counter is incremented from a 1 to a 2 and then to a 3 because main calls this function 3 times. The output will be taxes computed for person 1, taxes computed for person 2, taxes computed for person 3. Let's play around with the program a little more. I just added an extra line at the end of main. Just before the program ends, the cout statement displays I equals 3 at the end of the program, because even though I was initialized to 75 when it was declared, I was reinitialized to a 0 and then finally incremented to 3 by the for loop. Let's play around a little more. This time the for loop is written for int I equals 0, semicolon I less than 3, semicolon I plus plus. Notice that it has an int I equal 0, semicolon. The int I declares a new variable named I, which is local only to the for loop and can only be seen within the for loop. Now there are two different variables in main named I, the one that is initialized to 75 and the one that is part of the for loop. When the loop ends, its local variable no longer exists and the cout statement at the end of main displays I equals 75 at the end of the program. This is the end of the discussion for C and C++ scope, visibility, and lifetime. Bye for now.